Hey, this is Dave from VacuumWizard.com with my lovely wife, Lisa, vacuuming up the floors with the Hoover Linx Stick Cordless Vacuum. This is the performance on carpets for the Hoover Linx. Make sure you turn it on the second setting, though, because that activates the brush bar for carpeting. You can also notice the power meter when you're using the battery. It only has about 15 minutes of battery life. It has a swivel neck, but it doesn't swivel that much, so the maneuverability isn't that great on the vacuum. As far as cleaning up small particles, it did a good job. It only took about one pass to clean up all this flour that we tossed onto the floor. When we crushed up some crackers and threw it on the floor to simulate larger particles, it didn't do as good of a job. Some of the crackers got kicked back. Overall, it did a decent job on the larger particles, though. One nice thing on this Hoover Linx is that it can get under furniture very easily because of the lower head on it. Performance on hard floors was pretty good. We threw this flour up against the edge of the floor to see if it can get right to the edge, and it did a good job. It cleaned up the hard flooring pretty easily. Make sure you also don't have the brush bar on when you're cleaning hard flooring. With large particles, it cleaned up all of these too. Some of the larger particles did get stuck with the front of the vacuum, probably because they were so big. You can see one piece right there, but eventually it did get sucked up. When you suck up all these particles, it goes into a bagless dustbin. You can see the debris spinning around the bagless dustbin right there. Now for stairs, the Hoover Linx is not necessarily an ideal machine. It's pretty light. You can pick it up and go from step to step. However, it's just kind of awkward and you can't get really into the edges of the stairs as you go from one step to another. The noise level of the Hoover Linx is at about 75 decibels. This is a little bit quieter than your average vacuum, but it is a small vacuum. The filtration on it is not good. That means a lot of dust particles that get sucked up escape out of the exhaust. That's why you see the numbers going up on our airborne particle counter. Maintenance for the Hoover Linx involves charging the battery. You have to charge the battery for at least 3 hours to get a full charge. When you're done vacuuming, you have to empty the dust bin. A lot of dust gathers at the bottom, but don't forget there is the red center part that you take out because hair gets wrapped around it. And you have to manually pull this hair off. It's a messy job, but you've got to do it unless you don't want to be able to clean as well as you should with your Hoover vacuum. Every time you empty this dustbin, the manufacturer recommends that you wash this filter too. You're supposed to wash it out in cold water and then leave it to dry for 24 hours. So wash that filter every time. Put it all back together, put it back onto your Linx, and also take out the battery and recharge it. And don't leave it in the charger all the time. Once you've had it charged for about 3 hours, put it back into the vacuum.